I pray, may nothing hinder us in the mighty name of Jesus. You want us to look at your word so that we can live a better life and we please you. Lord, I pray you will help us through your word tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. You said your word, and you said your word, and your word healed and delivered from all destruction. I pray tonight your word will heal us spiritually and even physically in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray for those that are coming. I pray you will quickly step and they will join us in good time in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, because we know you have always answered our prayers. For in Jesus' mighty name, I have prayed. I welcome all to our night of discovery. This is a meeting that you and I, no one is supposed to be missing, because great things God is revealing to each and every one of us this ministry. Discovery, when you discover things that will help you in your spiritual life and also in your physical life. That will help us to grow, help us to please God, help us to get even the best of God. And that should tell you and me that we are not here to waste our time at all, but to get something from God, make use of it, and then our life will become better and better as we go. Last week we learned about Christ-like love, a must for every child of God. And he sent some even to the job, and even the sinner likewise. And that's thank you. If the Lord tell us not to do evil to our enemy, then we that pray we must love ourselves and not keep of evil, even from our heart towards ourselves. But brother, we pray for ourselves, how we will be lifting up in the spirit and in the physical, helping one another. The Lord.
That will let you know that that is what this ministry
stand for, to do exactly as God wants, as Jesus wants also. And I have to tell you that you being in this ministry, you're not in the wrong path at all. You see, Jesus letting us to know that the correction he came to do, that God in fact loved us to give to one another what we have need in time of prayer. And this giving is not for only those that have more. Even with the little you have, you can do something. Because God Himself, because He loved us so much, He gave His only begotten Son. Even while we are still sinners, even while we are committed sin, He still gave His Son for you and for me to be reconciled to Him by Him dying on the cross of Calvary for you and for me. If you say you are a child of God and you don't have the act of giving to those in need, then you are not ready at all. If you say you are a child of God and you want person to force you before you do your little giving, you are deceiving yourself. Let's look at John chapter 3, verse 16. Matter. As a child of God, we must give, because our God, our Father, gives. We ourselves must give the little we have to those in need. Don't just say, okay, I will receive it. You must also give to others. In John chapter 3, verse 16, he said, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. To the world, to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. You can see, God's only begotten Son, He gave it to us. Even while we're sinners, He gave it that you and I can be saved. Yeah, you see, Jesus encouraging us that you and I must try to give, no matter how little it is. And this is one of the things they have been telling us, even in the ministry we find ourselves. I must let you know that as many that are giving, they are also receiving. As they are giving, they are receiving. If you say you are not giving, then you will not be able to receive. So Jesus, in that Matthew chapter 6, verse 1, said, take it that you do not your hands before men to be seen of them. Otherwise, ye have no reward of your Father which is in heaven. So it is us to give to one another. Just as his Father has done, just as he himself has done. But in our giving, we must do it in secret. We must not show our giving at all. I've given this person and then you are now seeing all over that you have to ask. If not for me, this man will not have been what he is or what she is. Why? Because you that have, God is the one that gives to you also. So in our giving, we must not be this show off or showmanship in our giving. We must do it in humility, in secret, not letting others to know about our giving to others. Jesus that, oh, because I give somebody, you will announce it to every other party that you are giving. That shows that, yeah, your giving is not accepted by God.
Give that person something.
we are giving to them. No, that should not be our goal of giving. We will not be hypocritical in our giving to say that, yeah, we want to show ourselves that, yeah, I'm the one that gave, I'm the one that did this, I'm the one that did that. We must not do that at all. In John chapter 12, verse 43. John chapter 12, verse 43. Verse 43. For they love the praise of men more than the praise of God. God honoring them, more than God exalting them. And that is what God does not want. That is what Jesus does not want. That in their giving, in their good work, they must not show up at all. Because these Pharisees, they love the praise of men, that men will be hailing them, praising them wherever they are going. They love that more than what God will bless them with. They love the honor of men more than the honor of God. In Matthew chapter 16. Matthew chapter 16, verse 6 and verse 12. Verse 6 and verse 12. Then Jesus said unto them, take heed and beware of the leaving of the Pharisees and of the Sadducees. Verse 12. Then understood they how that he bade them not beware of the leaving of bread, but of the doctrine of the Pharisees and of the Sadducees. Disciples, that you must not follow the character of the Pharisees and the Sadducees. They are out of giving. They will have to show themselves. They are giving. They are proudness. They are not humble. Those type of life. He tells the disciples that they should be aware of those type of life and not follow those type of lifestyle. Because they are not humble at all. They are always very proud. They are showing them, they will be showing themselves, show off them themselves. And Jesus Christ is warning disciples that they should not follow this lifestyle of the Pharisees. That they will do good and we want men to know the good they have done. They give man, they will give man, and they want to let people know who are not men, they are the ones that have done this arm giving. But we, a children of God, must not be like them also. And Jesus is one of the disciples, is one of you and me also today, that in our giving, it should be go with humility, simplicity in our giving hands to the people in need. Not like the Pharisees, how they do their own. In Luke chapter 12. Verse 1 to verse 2. Luke chapter 12, from verse 1 to verse 2. In the meantime, when they were gathered together, an innumerable multitude of people, insomuch that they told one upon another, they began to say unto the disciples, first of all, beware ye of the leaven of the Pharisees, which is hypocrisy. For there is nothing covered that shall not be revealed, neither he that shall not be known. Follow, see, the light of the Pharisees because their lifestyle is full of hypocrisy. They will live, they will claim to be children of God, but in their attitude, they are sons and daughters of Satan. And that shows that they show themselves that they are children of God, but in every sense, they are the children of Satan. Because they are not living that lifestyle of Jesus, that Jesus Christ has come to teach them. But their lifestyle is a lifestyle of being proud, of showing themselves, of not doing what God wants at all.
Power of thy hand to do it. Verse 28. Say no.
Go and come again, and tomorrow I will give when thou hast it by thee. That when one is in need and we have the power, the ability to help, we must try to help that person. Must not say, oh, go and come back tomorrow when you have the means to assist that person. But if you don't have that at that point in time, there's nothing wrong to tell them, no, I don't have. There's nothing wrong about that. But if you have and display of need, you also, you should help your brother which is in need, help your sister which is in need. That shows that God encourages you and me to always give to those that request our help from us. Even though you will not be able to give the person as much as he or she needs, but the little you have, you can just say, oh, I don't have what, this is what I have, manage it and take care of yourself. But just to say you have the little and you have it also when you are sufficient and not giving the person at all, God will have to be his. Let's remember that when we call on God in prayer, we expect God to answer our prayers. When we call on God for need, we expect God to reminding God, hoping that He will help us in time of our need. You and I will do the same, even to our brothers and sisters and people who find around us. In James chapter 2, verse 15 to 16. James chapter 2, verse 15 to verse 16. If a brother or sister be naked and destitute of daily food, and one of you say unto them, depart in peace, be ye warm and filled, notwithstanding, ye give them not those things which are needed to the body, which are needful to the body, what doeth it profit? A brother or a sister have need, especially for this one you mentioned here, daily food to eat, more important food to eat, and clothes to wear. Why tell the person to go when you have it to give to your brother or to your sister? He said, what is the profit in it if you not give to that brother or give to that sister in need? In verse 17, he said, even so, faith, if it have not worked, is dead, be alone. Yeah, you see that, yes, you may believe in God, you may be a child of God, you may be a pastor, you may be a minister, you are doing other things for God. But if you are not doing it, then your faith is in vain. Especially for need of clothes, need of food, to be able to help ourselves. We must try to help one another. In James chapter 1, verse 27, pure religion and undefiled before God and the Father is this: to visit the fatherless and widow in their affliction keep himself unspotted from the religion. Religion is acceptable is the one whereby we help one another. He said, pure religion and undefiled is when we help one another in our affliction. In their, we help one another in affliction, in time of affliction. And secondly, when we keep ourselves unspotted from the world, when we avoid sin and not follow those in the world to commit evil or to do sin. Can you see that our worship of God is not complete if we are not giving, if we are not showing concern to one another? We must show love to one another. God loves us to do that. In 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 6 to 15. 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 6 to 15. God loves us when we show kindness to one another. In verse 6 to verse 15. But this I say, if we sow it sparingly, shall reap also sparingly. And if we sow it bountifully, shall reap also bountifully. Every man according as he purpose in his heart, so let him give, not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loveth a cheerful giver. And God is able to make all grace abound towards you, that ye always having all sufficiency in all things may abound to do good works, as it is written, he hath despised abroad, he hath given to the poor, his righteousness remaineth forever. Now he that ministereth seed to the sower, both minister bread for their food, and multiply their seed, sown, and increase the fruits of their righteousness, being enriched in every good thing to all bountifulness, which causes through us thanksgiving to God for the administration of this service, not only supplies the wants of the saints, but is abundant on also by many giving thanks unto God. Why? By the experiment of this ministration, the glorified God, for your professed subjection unto the gospel of Christ, and for your liberal distribution unto them and unto all men, and by your prayers for you, which long after you for the exceeding grace of God in you. Thanks be unto God for this unspeakable to give to one another. Only the fellow believers here who offer to give and as God wants them to do. And we saw that again, God loves a cheerful giver. God doesn't want us to give grudgingly or out of compulsion. No, God wants us to give cheerfully, simply, in simplicity, in humility, not forcing, not one forcing anyone. The one, the giving God love is the one that comes from the heart. Willingly, you give to God, you give to the brothers and sisters around you. And that's what we're known in this ministry. Nobody is forcing anyone to give. Nobody is forcing anyone to bring or give anything. But giving from the heart. You by yourself, if you see a need to the church or higher up, or your brother or sister, you guys said, find a way to give from your hand willingly by yourself. That shows the Spirit of God in it that nobody is forcing anyone to give. But as much as you have, you give the little you have to God. God who sees you will reward you even openly. But when you say you will not give at all, and you have the little you give, you have, and you say you are not going to give, at least little you have, let me still keep it. I'll see I have need to do something, and then you are not giving it to God, and are you helping man that is not good at all. Even the Bible says there are more blessings to them that give than to them that receive. In fact, the Bible will encourage us that we must walk so that we can help one another. In Ephesians chapter 4, verse 28. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 28. Let him that stole steal no more, but rather let him labor, working with his hands the things which is good, that he may have to give to him that needeth. One should not steal. Instead of stealing, work with your hand, labor with your hand, good work, not evil work. And as you labor, you have enough to be able to help those in need. And that is also telling me that you must not be idle at all. You must be doing something so that you can help yourself and help others around you. It is wrong to always depend on people to always help you all over and over again. You have to work so that you can help yourself and also help those that have need also. And so therefore, if we give and we are showing up to people that we are giving and letting them to give us praise or praise us because of what we have done, God does not honor such gift. God does not honor such gift. But the gift that God honors or the giving that God honors are those that we do it in secret. God that sees you in secret will reward you openly. Let's look back to that Matthew chapter 6.
Yeah. woman.
And she said,
woman,
whatever they put in the rain.
Yes, see, I'm not with you.
And what? On you can get my mind over for the mama she mean.
Look at my business.
And then you do wrong way. You know you won't want it. This small way it's I got out and see more.
Try to put an effort on the children.
Call it the more of all ye.
Thank you.
Oh, yeah. Verse 42 to verse 47. And they continue steadfast the apostle doctrine and fellowship, and in breaking of bread and prayers. And fear came upon every soul, and many wonders and signs were done by the apostles. And all that believed were together, and had all things common, and sold their possessions and goods, and parted them to all men, as every man had need. And they continued daily with one accord in the temple, and breaking bread from house to house, did eat their meat with gladness and singleness of heart, praising God and having favor with all the people. And the Lord added to the church daily such as she wait, the apostles are giving. They were not proud in their giving, they were cheerful in their giving, as poor have need, some sold their possession and bring the money to the apostles, and they distribute to those that have need of them. Disciples were doing it with gladness, singleness of heart, giving to themselves, giving to the brethren, as everyone had need.
Amen.
What happened? You were having favor with God continually. As you are giving, you are having favor with God, and you will find. And God was adding to them, believers, righteous people coming and were saved because we're doing what is right. Can you see that if we are doing good, helping ourselves, many we added to the church, we are helping ourselves, doing good to one another. The devil did not just stop here, he continued with that act of assisting themselves. In Acts chapter 4, verse 32 to 37. Verse 32. And the multitude of them that believed were of one heart and of one soul. Neither said any of them that all of the things which he possessed was his own, but they all have. But they had all things common, and with great power gave the apostles witness of the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great grace was upon them all. Neither was there any among them that lacked, for as many as were possessors of land or houses sold them and brought the price of the things that were sold, and laid them down at the apostles' feet. And distribution was made unto every man according as he had need. And Joseph, who by the apostle was some name Barnabas, which is being interpreted the son of consolation, a Levite, and of the country of Cyprus, having land, sold it and brought the money and laid it to Jesus, they begin to apply it to themselves. They are seeing how Jesus went out doing good, healing those that are sick, feeding those that are hungry. Look at them here doing the
same.
They said they provide as many that have need, they provide as those that have what, they give to those that have need, that I need. And at the end of the day, none of them was lacking anything. Can you see that in giving we will lack nothing, because as we help ourselves, all of us in turn we have much. But at the end of the day, God will bless those that are giving. Himself reward us because we are showing kindness among ourselves. In Hebrews chapter 6, verse 10. Hebrews chapter 6, verse 10. For God is not unrighteous to forget your work and labor of love, which you have shown towards his name, in that ye have ministered to the saints and do minister.